No, I think the team covering this is a lot of information. Good thing it rained the last few days, because we have to go through it. One of the things I've learned over the years, the best way to do it is to do it this way and start at the back, go backwards. It's, you get to see the end and the very last page with that overall lighting effect as to what the goal is at the finish of it. And as you read it backwards, it's interesting the amount of detail we do have. Because then you go through this whole very detailed lighting schematic of all the walkways, the restrooms, the stairways, the learning steps. You see the pieces that way and kind of get an understanding that as you go into then the canopy, the balconies, the walkways, the bridges, the stairs, and then into the pilings, the support. So it's actually easier to read it backwards. But it does have a lot of information, and there's still a lot more to go through. I also haven't read all 400 and some pages. But the good thing, I mean, we're answering the questions and listening to the comments today. That's really what this is about. All of the speakers on all sides of this issue have questions. There's one speaker said the design is just happening now, and that's true. That's why we need to do this. There's still questions unanswered. Stop spending money on a plan of unknowns. Things like that. There's the biggest commonality of everyone is there's a lot of questions to get answered. The permitting issues, the environmental issues, telling us we don't have all the information. That is what we're doing. And I think this is the right direction to go. Taking this, getting into that next step. And working on it, I think is real important. You know, we get into, should we stop or pause, whatever you want to call it. But we do need this information. Everyone in this room wants more information than what we have. You can't say this project isn't going to work because you haven't answered the question, and then don't spend the money to get the questions answered. We have to have a pathway the information, whether there's a referendum or not, and I believe there will be, but the best part of a referendum is an educated community that knows what they are being asked to do. And you can't say, well, this is never going to be permitted, or why are you building this in a hurricane zone, or you're not going to be able to clean it, or you don't know how much it's going to be to maintain it. Those are all really good questions, and I appreciate everyone for having that interest in asking them. But you have to answer those questions. We have an obligation to answer those questions. So I think this is a good step. I think the next step is going to further answer those questions. I was real pleased. As this design develops, instead of we were told that it would be cost overruns and be scaled down, the opposite is happening. Efficiencies are being found that, like you said, the circle marina, standardizing those planks, gives you the opportunity to make them wider. Those are all good things. It's not, oh, they're too expensive, let's make them smaller. The opposite is happening. The bridges are wider, the details, the promontory is bigger, the hub is bigger, the restaurant space is bigger. The more information you find out, the more details you work through, the more you listen to the public and work into those designs, what they have suggested, we're finding it's moving along, it's getting to be a better project, a more inclusive project, and a good thing. So I look forward to continuing this discussion. I'm glad the public's here. One of the speakers said that heart aches and this is horrible. I don't think it is. I think it's a good discussion. It's good to hear people are passionate and they're paying attention and they want to be involved in this thing. So I think it's important. I think on the question today, people need to understand there are multiple gauges for understanding what the community wants. You can look at surveys, emails, telephone calls, conversations at the gas station, put all those things together. If this week was the measure, it was probably 10 to 1 in favor of moving forward on the emails this week. If you went in this room, right now it's 50-50 on red shirts and blue shirts. You have to gauge all those things. The survey was interesting, you know, and yes, you're right, it said 67%. Several months ago, 80% against it. So you could track the surveys and saying support is growing for this. Mr. Risser said, I wrote it down because I thought it was good, he wants to vote today because things might change by August. That says it all. Things are going to change by August.
Sir, I did not say that. I said because I wanted my life back.
Well, you said that too, but the officer, I wrote it down. I did write it down because you said things might, after you said you want your life back, you said you wanted to vote today because things might change by August. And I tell you what, more information will give people more opportunities, more chances to weigh in, a more refined design, moving now from concept into design, into final design, really gets to what this project is going to be. So I think this is a good step. I think we do need to move forward and continue answering the questions so that the public's informed on what is going on, what is the cost, what is the maintenance, what is all these issues. I think that's the right thing to do.